It's Professor Dave. Let's learn about perimeters.
He knows a lot about all kinds of stuff, Professor Dave explains.
Sometimes in movies, someone will shout, "Secure the perimeter!" What this means is to guard or enclose the boundary of an area so that no one gets in or out. In geometry, the word perimeter has a similar meaning. It's the distance around a shape or figure. Finding the perimeter of a polygon is usually pretty easy. We just have to add up the lengths of all the sides, and that will give us the distance around the shape. This was one of the earliest mathematical necessities, as early farmers had to know how much material they needed to enclose their land and guard their animals or crops. Here is an irregular pentagon. Given these side lengths, we just add them up, and that's the perimeter. This is the same thing as asking, if you walked along each edge of the shape, all the way back to where you started, how far did you walk? If we don't know one or more of the sides, we can usually calculate them depending on what shape we are looking at. First, let's look at rectangles. These have both a length and a width. Since there are four sides total, two lengths and two widths, the perimeter of a rectangle is equal to L plus W plus L plus W, or 2L plus 2W. So if the dimensions of a rectangle are 4 by 2, we can just plug these into the equation, and we see that we get 12 for the perimeter. For squares, it's even simpler. It's just the side length times 4, since all the sides are the same. Sometimes we may be given a perimeter problem that we can do algebra with. Say we have a rectangle with a perimeter of 24, and its length is 3 times its width. What are the dimensions of the rectangle? Well, we know that 2L plus 2W must equal 24. We also know that L equals 3W. Remember how to solve two equations with two unknowns by substitution? Let's put 3W in place of L in this equation, which gives us 6W plus 2W, or 8W, equals 24. We divide by 8, W must be 3, and therefore L must be 9. The rectangle is 3 by 9. If we have a triangle, again, we add up the sides, and if we have a right triangle with an unknown length, we know that we can use the Pythagorean theorem to find the missing side. Like this one, if the legs are 3 and 4, we know the hypotenuse must be 5, and the perimeter is therefore 12. Sometimes we may be given an irregular polygon like this one, with some of the side lengths filled in and others not. This isn't too hard once we realize that we can figure out the missing side lengths by looking at the others and imagining a rectangle behind this shape. If these two sides add up to become one side of the imaginary rectangle, then these two sides must add up to the same value. So we just find the difference to label the missing side. We can do this for all the missing sides. And then we just add up all the side lengths to get the perimeter. So that's all we need to know to find the perimeter of any polygon. Remember, this works for shapes made of straight line segments only. When we introduce curvature, things get much trickier very quickly. And if the curvature is not perfectly circular, we will need calculus to do it. We aren't there yet. But speaking of curvature, we haven't discussed circles very much up to this point. So let's move on to those next, right after we check comprehension. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.